Hey, what's up guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial with UX Mate. Today we're going to learn how to create a cool simple rig using Rigify in Blender with an easy and simple method. So without any further ado, let's jump into the Blender rigging process and start rigging a cool character. Well, if you are not subscribed to the channel, then do it right now, because if you're not doing that, then you're going to miss a lot of exciting notifications for all our future uploads. I have this cool simple pick character. You can use any character, any humanoid character you want, and we are going to use Rigify. So make sure you already activated Rigify add-on. If you don't know how to activate, just go to the edit, go to the preferences, go into the add-ons tab in the preferences window, and you can search for the Rigify. It would be there. You just have to click on this checkbox and it will enable the Rigify plugin or Rigify add-on in Blender. Okay, so make sure you have enabled this, and I'll just close this preferences window, and now I can use Rigify plugin to create the nice rig. So let's go to the add and let's go to the armature, and in the basics, if you want to create a complex humanoid rig, you can go to the human Metarig. But if you want a simple, cool, easy rig, let's just go to the armature basics and click on basic human Metarig. Now you'd be seeing it has added this Metarig, but it is not visible in front of the character. So just to make sure that you can see all the bones in front of the character, that helps you to create and map the bones properly, we would be enabling viewport display in front. So when you have selected the Metarig, just go to the object settings, and under that you just have to scroll down and find the viewport display settings here and just click on in front. So this will make sure that your rig is visible in front of your character from any views or, you know, any angle in your viewport. I'll go to the front view and I'll go to the edit mode of the Metarig. To go to the edit mode, you can just click here on the edit mode, or you can simply hit tab on the keyboard. That will enable the edit mode. Now you need to make sure that you align all the bones of this Metarig with your character. And to do this, I'll simply select the bones here and make sure you enable the symmetry here. Just go to the symmetry options here, and as we are already in the front mode, it is just enabling for the X mode, and that's what for the X axis, and that's what we want. So make sure you enable the symmetry. You can do it from this drop down option as well, as just click on this X icon here next to the symmetry. So when you activate the symmetry, you just have to edit one side of the armature and other side will be automatically edited. Now we'll just move everything to the bottom and then select these bones here for the leg, and I'll scale them down. To scale them down, just hit yes on the keyboard, and then you can use same shortcuts which you use to move and scale your normal objects in the Blender. So just to move, use G on the keyboard and move it and place it near legs. Make sure you align these joints as close as possible with your character, because this is going to be used to add the automatic weight mapping later in the tutorial. So make sure all your bones are properly aligned with your character. Take your time, don't be in rush. Practice this for a couple of times. If you are getting any errors later, make sure you are not selecting individual bones like this. You are selecting the joints properly with a select tool, because if you select individual bones, then there is a chance that you break the parent-child relationship of the bones or of the rig. So make sure you select both bones together when you are moving them and not a single bone. So that will make sure that your hierarchy is maintained as it is in the Metarig. Okay, now I'm good with the legs. You can just adjust a little bit as per your character. Make sure you take your time to align these bones properly with your character, and there's no rush, just do it slowly. You can pause the video for a while and just, you know, align all your bones, or you can just watch me how I'm aligning them with my character and then do it yourself, whichever you prefer, whichever way you prefer, you can do it. So I'll just quickly align them for the tutorial. But when you are doing that, make sure you are doing it properly in, you know, correct approach. These bones are here for the breasts, other for the chest, because we are using the humanoid structure. If you want, you can delete extra bones, but if you delete any extra bones, then you will not able to generate the rig controller. If you just want to animate using the bones itself without any rig controllers, feel free to delete the extra bones. But if you delete extra bones, make sure you don't break the hierarchy of the parent-child relationships. Okay, so I'll just go to the head and quickly align these bones, just move it to the top and something like this. Okay, we have done it from the front view. Just cross check it in all other views or in the perspective view. Now you can see my bones are going out of the hand, so I'll just quickly go to the top view and make sure I align them properly. So I'll select both of them. If you feel any trouble to see the mesh, you can just enable the x-ray mode here in the Blender. Just click here and you can activate the x-ray mode. And now you can see these are my ears and these are my hands. So I can just adjust the bones quickly and as we have already activated symmetry, you don't need to worry about the other side. It will be automatically updated. So I'll just quickly align the bones in other views as well. Great, this looks good. We can just move them a little bit inside. And the way you align the bones or the adjust the bones, your weighting process would be easier and you'd be able to, you know, create the cool rigs very quickly and very easily. Okay, now this looks good to me and now we can just go to the weighting process. I'll just go outside the edit mode. I'll just switch off the x-ray vision and now I can see my all bones are properly aligned. I will select my mesh first, then the rig, then just hit Ctrl P, and here under Armature Deform you can select with automatic weights. So that will automatically create the weights for all our bones. And just to see if, you know, we have created the proper weights, you can just select the bone, select the object and just go to the weight paint mode. And now you can see when you select any individual bone, you can see the weight applied to that bone here. So if this is red, then 100% of the weight is applied. If this is blue, then 0% of the weight is applied for the bone. So if you take example of this bone here, and all those blue parts which are here will not affected with this bone. So if I, you know, move this bone here, you can see all other parts which are completely blue are not getting affected with this bone's movement. So, and now you can see here I have this red and then slowly faded towards the blue. So wherever we have this dark red patch, that means 100% of the weight of the bone is applied. And wherever we have, you know, this blue color, that is 0% of the weight is applied. Now you can change weight of all these automatic bones if you don't see a proper weightage is applied as per your mesh. But in most of the cases, if you align the bones properly, then Blender will automatically apply the weight. And just to show you how you can change the weight of any object, here you can see all those different weight painting brushes. This is a simple draw brush where you can simply adjust the weight and the strength of this brush and the radius of this brush and just, you know, click on your object. And when I click here, you can see a red patch is getting added. And if you do weight 0, in that case it will remove all the weight for this selected bone and it will remove the weight. So when I remove, for example, all this weight from here for this particular bone, and when I try to rotate this bone, you can see the other affected area is getting, you know, moved or deformed, but the center part where we have zero deformation, that is not getting affected at all. So I'll just remove all the weight here For example, from entire mesh, and now when I try to rotate, you can see nothing is getting affected, just you know this small part where still we have some light green highlighted weight that is getting affected. And now when I removed entire weight, there would be some small weight, a little bit weight, you can see those only parts are getting affected, but all other parts are not getting affected with this. And now to repaint it again, there are multiple ways. You can use the blur tool, you can use the average tool that will average out the weight, you can use this gradient. I feel this is a nice tool, so you can adjust the weight to 100% and strength somewhere around 0.5, and you can just draw a nice gradient which will basically create the follow off, you know, on entire object. And now you can see when I select this bone and try to rotate, my weights are applied back to the mesh for that particular bone. So now we have applied the weight and we have aligned all our bones. Now time to check out our poses. So to go to the pose mode, you can just, you know, go to the object mode, select the rig, and then go to the pose mode. Now when you animate any bone in the pose mode, you can see the objects which have weight for that particular bone are getting animated. And then in similar fashion, you can create all your complex animations. So to create animations, either you can do it in the layout mode, or you can go to the animation mode and make sure you are on the zeroth frame or wherever you want your animation to be started. So let's create a simple motion here. I am on the zeroth frame. Make sure you toggle on this auto keyframing option, where you know whenever you move your bones, it will automatically add a keyframe. So let's just enable the auto keying feature here, and let's keep everything on the default. So just select the bone, hit on the R, and just, you know, to create an automatic keyframe, hit R on the keyboard and just click on the bone. That will automatically add a keyframe here. I'll select the other bone, I'll just hit R on the keyboard. I'm not moving anything, I'm simply just clicking on the bone to add the keyframe on the current rotation position. Okay. In same way, I'll do it for some other bones, and just to show you some simple animation here. Okay, and now I'll move a couple of frames forward, let's say 20 frames, and let's move these bones slightly towards the backward. Oops. You can go to the different views here. I'll simply move it a little bit backward. I'll again go to the front view. I'll just rotate these bones a little bit up. Okay, and now you can go back to the perspective mode. Just go to the zeroth frame, define your start and end keyframes here. I have start at 0, end at 24, and I'll just hit play button. It will play the animation. You can see the camera view of the same animation here. If you don't want to see the bones here, you can simply hide them here in the hierarchy or in the collection panel here. And now you can see we have created this nice, cool, simple animation with a simple rig in Blender. So I hope you have enjoyed this video, and make sure to let me know in the comments if this was helpful for you. And yep, that's it. Till the next video, keep watching, keep learning, keep designing.